Hey guys, welcome on this video. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix. I don't know if you know guys, but Microsoft decided to block local accounts. So local-only commands are removed. So what does this mean is that they want users to force creating online account instead of offline account or local account. In the latest version of Windows 11 25H2, in the developer mode is not released yet for the public, but it will be very soon. When you buy a new computer, new laptop, on the first setup of the Windows, now the methods that we used before will not work anymore. So let's say the method that we use with OOBE/bypassNRO, on the other one that is create local only, so two methods, the famous methods that we used before in other video tutorials, now Microsoft stopped these methods. Okay, but today in this video tutorial, guys, I'm going to show you new method how to do this. As always, we have a method. I've started the latest version of Windows 11 from Insider Purview developer channel. So the latest build, I'm going to show you that this command doesn't work anymore and new command will be today. So guys, let's go directly to the point and let's test. So, okay guys, here I am on my virtual machine here and I have here the latest version, developer version of Windows 11, the latest one. And let me show you first of all the post. Okay, here on a Tips to Fix website, I did this post that you can find all the commands and everything that I did for you and prepared. Now look at this, guys, local machine only. Let me check the official Microsoft blog page. Look at this, local only commands removed. It means that they forced you guys to use online account in your computer. It means like you are not able now to create a local account. Here we are today to show you a method how to do this. Even these methods are removed. Okay, so we will check it together. Okay, now we are removing known mechanism for creating a local account in the Windows setup experience OOBE. Nothing wrong, guys, creating Microsoft account, online account. And I suggest you guys have a Microsoft account. Why not create it one? Create it for free. I mean, it's good to have one. I have Microsoft account. I use it. So first of all, we are going to check if this command really works or really blocked. Or I mean, let me set up this first setup here. I'm on the latest version. You can name your PC. Click next. It will restart your computer. If you are on Windows 11 Pro, guys, click this setup for work or school. And now, with this method, you can bypass very, very easily. But if you are on home, you will not see this option. You see, domain join instead, and voila, you're done. Okay, now, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to go back, set for personal use. You're stuck here, unlock Microsoft experience, sign in. So what to do in this case? Sign in options, forgot username, email. Now guys, what you are going to do, watch carefully. In your keyboard, you are going to press here, shift button and this F10, see? You see, you will see the CMD will pop up. Now, if you are on laptop, let me show you. But in some laptops, you have to keep this FN button, press and click shift and click F10. That's the point. This is how you can see this CMD, okay? If it doesn't work with shift and F10. Look at this. Shift F10 doesn't work on my laptop, okay? If your case is the same, like here, doesn't work. So you have to keep this FN, Shift, F10, it will show up. Okay, let's continue the process. Okay, now let's try the command with OOBE/bypassNRO. Enter. OOBE is not recognized as internal or external command. That's the point. This is what I'm talking about. You will see this message on new computers with 25H2, but the latest update that is coming soon. I'm on a developer version, okay? Now what I'm going to do, let's try another one. Let's restart ms-cxh:localonly. What it will happen here? Restart your computer, it will end up in this loop. again and again. So this is what they said. They remove this command. Now, skip again. Check for updates again. Let's open up the cmd command again, shift and F10. Here we are. Now what I'm going to do. This new method, guys, it will work great. If you see here in my GitHub page, you will see this script. This is the command that we are going to do. Click the link on the description, you will see these cmd commands. I created this script for you. I will thank also Chris Titus Tech. This guy is amazing. He did great job with his script based on his I created mine. But the only difference is that when I create this unattend.xml, if you go and see, I didn't touch a Windows programs and Windows bloatware or something. Windows, it will be original, will be untouched. So this is the website that I created this unattended.xml. I will choose the file here and let me show you what's inside here. So guys, you will see that Windows English version is the same. So the only thing that we did here is let Windows generate random computer name, password will be empty and will do not expire. All of these are unchecked. It's clean and I didn't touch any Windows features or Windows apps. So now what are you going to do here on CMD? Now you have to type curl here. -L tips to fix.com/bypass space again. So you see one space again and type here -O. Here is the command. Space again. Type skip.cmd. So what does this command do? It will copy my bypasser directly from GitHub. It will bring it here on your computer on a system32 and it will use it to bypass this window. Easy. Okay? And it will create the file with this name, skip. Click enter. Oh, it's downloaded successfully. The last command is just type here the same name. Skip, you see this? Skip CMD? The same. -CMD. Enter. Process cleanup. Okay. Just a moment. It restart your computer automatically, guys. It will create a local account automatically for you. It's easy, huh? But let's see if this method will work. Click yes again, skip, remove. I didn't remove internet. Okay, so I think we are done, guys, getting things ready for you. So this little script works really well. And also you will find the script on GitHub page. You will find the command on my tips to fix website. So here it is, guys. That's it. Your computer name will be admin and it's local account. Now, if you wanted to change the name, what you are going to do, type run and control. This control will bring you the old control panel. I really like this. It's old method, old fashioned, but I love it. Change your account name, put your name here, change the name of your computer, rename this PC if you don't want this name. Maybe it will ask you to restart the computer. Restart it later. Now let's go to Windows. I'm going to go to system32 and let's see what is inside. We create those files. Skip. I created this one, you see. I did some tests. I created this skip file. I'm going to delete it. If you don't want this anymore, and this one is what is created from. You see here, if you go to edit, you will see what is inside. So now I'm going to delete this cmd command from the system32, because I don't need here anymore. I'm going to delete because it's not mine now. I'm completely clear in my computer. Restart your computer. And now, so here it is. Here in my website are all commands that you need. Use this method. If you have any problem, just write me comment on a comment area. So this was the command for my script. If you are on Windows 11 25H2 Home Edition, you have to use this method that I'm showing on the video. But if you are on a Windows 11 25H2 Pro version, you can click that option, join domain instead. Set up for school or for business. It's because it's a pro version of Windows and it will work. It will allow you to create a local account. So if you're still on Windows 10, guys, then you are thinking to go in Windows 11, upgrade your Windows 10. I did another video tutorial, guys, for this, how to upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11 25H2 on unsupported computers. Go ahead, watch it and let me know in comment area. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. I need you, my friend, here in my channel, in my community. I will make great video tutorials only for you. As always, God loves you and God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.